How are you? I hope you are doing well. Did you read the text carefully? Yes. The last class we completed our second chapter. Which is the second chapter? The second chapter is the Ethiopian slave. The Ethiopian slave. We have completed it, and today we are going to do the comprehensive work in the text. Today we are going to do the comprehension in the text. Let us do the comprehension in the text. You take page number 16 of your text. Here, page number 16. Can you see this? Yes, page number 16 in your text. Here is sentence making. First one is sentence making. Sentence making means we will get a word, and with that word we can make sentences, meaningful sentences. Unless we don't know the meaning of the word, we couldn't make the sentence. First you study the meaning, first you understand the meaning of that word, and then only we can make sentences. First word, courtier. First one, courtier. C-O-U-R-T-I-E-R. Courtier. What is the meaning of courtier? Do you know the meaning of courtier? Yes, courtier means king's advisor. The person who advises the king is called a courtier. Okay, is it clear? Who is a courtier? The person who advises the king, that means who give guidance to the king for his rule. The guidance is given by courtiers. Every king has so many courtiers, and the courtier means the person who advises the king. Then can you make a sentence including the word courtier? Courtier. Yes. Do you heard about Birbal? Birbal stories? Do you read Birbal stories? Yes. Who is Birbal? Who is Birbal? Birbal is the courtier of Emperor Akbar. Birbal is the courtier of Emperor Akbar. Okay, let us write this one as Birbal, B-I-R-B-A-L, Birbal was the courtier of courtier, C-O-U-R-T-I-E-R, courtier of Emperor Akbar, Emperor Akbar, Emperor Akbar. Who is Birbal? Birbal was the courtier of Emperor Akbar. Write neatly in the space provided. You have a space in the text, and you use your pencils. Using your pencils, you write neatly. Birbal was the courtier of Emperor Akbar. Who was Birbal? Birbal was the courtier of Emperor Akbar. Second one, second word is precious. P-R-E-C-I-O-U-S. Second word is precious. What is precious? What is the meaning of precious? What do we mean by precious? Precious means having great value, that means valuable. Precious means valuable, having great value. Precious. Then, can anybody make a sentence using precious? Every day we is hearing so many things precious. There is a slogan. What is the slogan? Water is precious, don't waste it. Everybody heard that slogan. Water is precious, don't waste it. It is valuable thing. Water is valuable, don't waste it. Let us make a sentence. Water is precious. P-R-E-C-I-O-U-S. Precious. Don't waste it. Don't waste it. Waste. W-A-S-T-E. Waste it. Water is precious. Don't waste it. Water is precious. Don't waste it. Do you understand the meaning of the sentence? Yes. The third word is casket. Casket. What is casket? Third one, casket. Spelling C-A-S-K-E-T. Casket. What is a casket? A casket is a small ornamental box of valuables. A small box that contains valuable things, precious things. We put the precious things like our ornaments, jewels, etc. inside a casket. That is called a casket. Then let us make a sentence using the word casket. She has a beautifully decorated casket. You had already seen that in this chapter there is a casket, and the casket was on the back of the camel. When the camel stumbled and fell down, the casket fell on the ground, and the precious stones like diamond, rubies and pearls scattered all over the ground. Here she has a beautifully decorated casket. Write with me. She has a beautifully decorated, beautifully, beautifully decorated, decorate, decorated casket. Okay, is it clear? We finished writing. She has a beautifully decorated casket. Okay, do we finish writing? Then the next word is devotion. What is the meaning of devotion? Great love or loyalty. Loyalty means faithfulness. What is the meaning of loyalty? Faithfulness. And here who is loyal? The Ethiopian slave is very loyal, faithful. And devotion.
That are not complete, and two options are there.
and you choose the correct answer and write in the space and tick the correct answer. First one, the Ethiopian slave was a dash. Listen, first one, the Ethiopian slave was a dash. Options: fair and handsome. Second one, dark and ugly. All of you know the answer. Say the answer loudly. The Ethiopian slave was say loudly. The Ethiopian slave was dark and ugly. The Ethiopian slave was dark and ugly. Tick the second option. Dark and ugly. Ugly means not beautiful. Bad looking. Dark and ugly. Do you get the point? Do you tick the second option? Yes. Then second one. According to the caliph. Listen here. According to the caliph. There are two options. Quality of soul and the character was important. First option. Quality of soul and the character was important. Second option. Only diamonds were precious. What was the opinion of the caliph? Yes. According to the caliph, quality of the soul and the character was important. Which one was correct? First option was correct. Tick the first option. Quality of the soul and the character was important. Quality of the soul. Q-U-A-L-I-T-Y. Quality of the soul and character was important. Character was important. Third one, when the casket fell, what happened when the casket fell? Two options are there. All slaves stood at attention. Is it correct? No. Let us hear the second option. All slaves except the ugly one ran to collect the jewels. Which one is correct, first or second? Okay, the second one is correct. The second one is correct. Which was the second option? When the casket fell, all slaves except the ugly ran to collect the jewels. It is correct. Second option is correct. You tick the second option. You tick the second option. All slaves except the ugly one. All slaves except E-X-C-E-P-T. The ugly one ran to collect the jewels. Ran to collect the jewels. Then comprehension C, page number 17, page number 17, last part. Comprehension C, state if the following statements are true or false. There are 7 sentences. State whether it is true or false. Here is a column. If it is true, you can write T there, and if it is false, you can write a F there in the column. First one, the caliph had many slaves. Is it true or false? The caliph had many slaves. True. It is true. You put a tick mark in the first column. There are 7 columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. First one, the caliph had many slaves. It is true. So you write T here. True. You write the letter T in the first column. Then he loved all of them equally. The caliph loved all of them equally. Is it true? No. He did not love all of them equally. Then we can write yeah. It is a false statement. It is a false statement. So we write F in the column. third one. The Ethiopian slave was very smart. Is he smart? No, he is not smart. So that statement is also incorrect. So we write F in the third one. F. Write with me, otherwise you will get mistaken. First one true, second one false, third one also false. Fourth one. The Ethiopian slave was faithful. Yes, it is a correct statement. It is true. So we write T here. T. It is true. Next one, fifth one. The Ethiopian slave went to pick the jewels. Do he went? No. He doesn't went. Then it is false. Fifth one. It is false. So we write F in the fourth. Sixth one. The other slaves ran to collect the jewels. It is correct. So we write it is true. The other slaves ran to collect jewels. It is true. So we can write T in the order. The letter T in the order. Then the last one. The other slaves were jealous of the Ethiopian slave. It is a correct statement. So it is true. So we can write which letter? Yes, T. Here we can write T in this one. Is it clear? I will read it one more time for you. You listen whether you are written the correct letter. The caliph had many slaves. True, it is T. He loved all of them equally. It is incorrect. So we write F. The Ethiopian slave was very smart. No. So we write false. Next one, the Ethiopian slave was faithful. It is a correct statement. So we write T. Then fifth one, the Ethiopian slave went to pick the jewels. It is incorrect. It is false. So we write F in the fifth order. Sixth, the other slaves ran to collect the jewels. It is a true statement. So we write T. Last one, the other slaves were jealous of the Ethiopian slave. It is a correct statement. So we write T in the last column. T for true and F for false. Let us move on to the next page. Replace, next one, D. Comprehension D. Replace the underlined word with the opposite word. We have studied so many opposite words. At the beginning of the chapter, there was words to write the opposite. We had written it earlier. And now, the Ethiopian slave was beautiful and fair. Write the underlined words are beautiful and fair. The Ethiopian slave was, let us write in the blank. There is a blank space and we should write in the blank space. All of you take your pencils and write in the text. Take your test. Page number 18, first part. The Ethiopian slave was beautiful and fair. First one. The Ethiopian slave was beautiful. What is the opposite of beautiful? Ugly. Opposite of beautiful? Ugly. Underline the word ugly. And fair. F-A-I-R. What is the opposite of fair? Fair colored complexion. When we are saying about, when we are talking about our complexion, the skin color, we said fair and dark. Ugly and dark. D-A-R-K. Opposite of fair, dark. Opposite of beautiful, ugly. Opposite of fair, dark. We finish writing. Write first. The Ethiopian slave was opposite of beautiful, ugly. Opposite of fair, dark. Okay. Then let us move on to the next one. Second one. The caliph loved him the least. Least means not so much, least, less count, least. Then what is the opposite of least? Let us write. The caliph. The caliph loved him the L-O-V-E-D, loved him the dash, opposite of least, most, M-O-S-T, loved him the most. The caliph loved him the most. After writing, you underline the word most. It is the opposite of least. The Ethiopian slave was disloyal. Disloyal. Third one. The Ethiopian slave was. Ethiopian slave was. Disloyal. What is the opposite of disloyal? Write the opposite of the underlined words here. Disloyal is underlined. Disloyal. Loyal. Faithful. Meaning faithful. L-O-Y-A-L. The Ethiopian slave is loyal. L-O-Y-A-L. Loyal. Fourth one. The jewels were in a big casket. The jewels were in a big casket. The jewels, J-E-W-E-L-S, jewels, were in a big, opposite of big. You write the opposite of big here. Opposite of big? Say louder. Opposite of big? Small. S-M-A-L-L. Small casket. C-A-S-K-E-T. Underline the opposite words. Okay? Opposite of beautiful? Ugly. U-G-L-Y. Ugly. Opposite of fair? Dark. D-A-R-K. Dark. Opposite of least, most, M-O-S-T. Opposite of disloyal, loyal, L-O-Y-A-L. Opposite of big, small, S-M-A-L-L. Next exercise, comprehension E. Complete the sentences from the story. Complete the sentences from the story. You got already read the text so many times and you can easily do this work. You can easily do this work. That is why I told you earlier that every day you should go through the text, read the text 4 or 5 times, and that will help you in later works. Here, the first sentence is, listen here. The first sentence is, the camel was carrying Dash. First one, listen. The camel was carrying, C-A-R-R-Y-I-N-G, carrying Dash. The camel was carrying Dash. A huge casket of precious stones. The camel was carrying a huge casket of precious stones. Here is a line for you. You write in the line, a huge casket of, H-U-G-E, huge, spelling H-U-G-E, huge casket, C-A-S-K-E-T, casket of precious stones, P-R-E-C-I-O-U-S, precious stones, S-T-O-N-E-S. Okay, listen here. The camel was carrying a huge casket of precious stones. You write in the space provided in the text. Here is a space for you, blank space for you. You write in the same space. Okay, second one. The casket was broken and Dash. Second one. The casket was broken. Casket was broken. dash. The casket was broken and dash. And I am going to fill the dash. You also write with me. And the diamonds, D-I-A-M-O-N-D-S, diamonds. Rubies, R-U-B-I-E-S, rubies. And P-E-A-R-L-S, pearls. The diamonds, rubies and pearls were scattered all over. Where? W-E-R-E, where? Scattered. S-C-C-A-T-T-E-R-E-D, scattered all over. All over. Then the third one. The third one. Real beauty lies in dash. Real beauty lies in dash. Listen here. Real beauty. Spelling of beauty. B-E-A-U-T-Y. Beauty lies in L-I-E-S. Lies in real beauty. Real beauty lies in dash. The quality of soul and character. Real beauty lies in the quality of soul. Q-U-A-L-I-T-Y. Quality of soul. S-O-U-L. Quality of soul and character. C-H-A-R-A-C-T-E-R. Character. C-H-A-R-A-C-T-E-R. Character. The quality of soul and character. Do all of you finish? Do you finish writing? Don't get the space as blank. You fill the blanks with this. Let us move on to the next one. Filling the blanks, choose the word from the clue box. Here is a clue box for you. All of you listen. Here is a clue box, that is green colored clue box here. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 words are there in the clue box. Which are the words? Ugly, devotion, love, fell down, dark and stumbled. And here are three sentences and let us filling the blanks with the appropriate words. Filling the blanks with the appropriate words. Appropriate, what is the meaning of appropriate? Suitable. Appropriate means suitable. First one. The Ethiopian slave was very dash and dash. Which one matches that place? The Ethiopian slave was very. You write along with me, otherwise it will be confused. The Ethiopian slave was very dash and dash. Dash and is there already in the text? First one. The Ethiopian slave was dash and dash. Which are the words to describe the Ethiopian slave? Yes, ugly and dark. U-G-L-Y. Ugly and dark. D-A-R-K. Is it clear? Do you have any doubt? No. Then, the Ethiopian slave was very ugly and dark. Second one. Somehow one of the camel dashed and dashed. One of the camel, somehow, one of the camel, what happened to the camel? Stumbled and fell down. There is two words, stumbled and fell down. Second one, S-T-U, the first dash you write, S-T-U-M-B-L-E-D, stumbled. Which is the word? Stumbled, S-T-U-M-B-L-E-D, stumbled and fell down. And is already there in the text and you don't write the word and. And fell down. F-E-L-L-D-O-W-N. Dash and dash. Which are the words? Stumbled. S-T-U-M-B-L-E-D. Stumbled. And fell down. stumbled and fell down. Third one, he had shown the cali his unstinted dash and dash. Which are the words? Love and devotion. Which are the two words? Love and devotion. Third one, dash and dash. Which are the suitable words? Love. In the first dash you write love. L-O-V-E. Love. And in the second dash, devotion. D-E-V-O-T-I-O-N. Devotion. D-E-V-O-T-I-O-N. Devotion. What? Love and devotion. That's our Then there is a writing section. Loyalty and devotion are two qualities of a dog. Here listen. Loyalty and devotion are two qualities of a dog. Do you know any other animal with such qualities? There is a kangaroo. We got study here about a kangaroo who showed loyalty and love towards the family members. There is a mongoose, not kangaroo. There is one of the mongoose which killed a snake and a mongoose. In a village near a jungle, there lived a farmer and his wife. They had a small baby. In their house, there was a mongoose who was like a family member. They loved him like their own child. The mongoose also protected and guarded the baby. One day, what happened? Let us complete the story. Here is no space, enough space to complete the story that I will give you in the notes. Okay, next, grammar power. We are going to study grammar power. We are going to study grammar power. Today let us wind up the class for today. And let us continue in the next class. Let us do the other exercises in the next class. Thank you.